I've made a copy of ODB 69 and I'm calling this one ODB 70 Reports Conditional. I'm going to create a new report. I'm going into Reports and I'm going to use the wizard to create our report. I'm going to close the Add Field dialog box. And I want to create this report from the Employees table. I'm going to select the employee ID, last name, first name, department ID, and hourly wage. Instead of going to Next, I'm just going to skip down to Create Report. I'm going to rename this to ODB 70 Conditional and create the report. Our report shows the department ID as a number. This isn't going to help us too much. I want to change that to show the department name. I'm going to close the report and edit the report. So I'm right-clicking and selecting Edit. The first thing I want to do is select the department ID, open up the properties, and change that from department ID to say department. Now I'm going to select the department ID detail field. I'm coming over to data, and then I'm going to open up the dialog box by clicking on the dot 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 box. We see the formula says equals department ID. I'm going to select that and delete it. Now we just have an equal sign. I'm going to come up to the category and select logical. I just happen to know that the one I'm looking for, if, is in logical. I could have searched the entire list, but I wanted to shorten down the list. Selecting if shows us if, then the test, then value, and otherwise value. Going to double click. Here we see equals if in our outer parentheses, and here's the three expressions. The first thing is the test. I'm going to click on this button that says shrink, and I'm going to select the department ID. Double-clicking that puts department ID in our test. I want to say where the department ID equals 6. Where I'm getting this from, let's go back to our database, going into tables, and then I'm going to bring up our department table. We see that department ID number 6 is security, 5 is marketing, and so on all the way down to 0, which is unassigned. We're going to look at 6 and make those security. Back at our function wizard, I've got the test to be department ID equals 6. When it is, I'm going to put a double quote and type in security. Our otherwise value will be the department ID. Clicking that shrink button again brings up our fields. Double-clicking department ID shows us our total if. If department ID equals 6, put in security. Otherwise, put in the department ID. Let's run this and see if it works. We see that employees 22 and 23 are in the security department, and the others are not. That works well for security. Let's try and add in Department 5, Marketing. I'm going to open back up our dialog box. And instead of Department ID in our otherwise, I'm going to double click if again and put in another if. Now I'm going to put in if Department ID equals 5, Then the value I want is marketing inside of the double quotes. Otherwise, I want to put in the department ID. Clicking OK, and let's run this. Now we see that employee ID 3 is in the marketing department. We have our security, and we've got three more marketing on our second page. The rest are all not in security or marketing. Looking at this formula, it's a little complicated. And if we want to add in all six this way, it can get very tedious and there's a lot of opportunity for mistakes. But luckily, LibreOffice allows us to put in spaces and carriage returns. To make things a little easier to read, I've created a text file with our nested if statements. So the first one is if the department ID equals 6, put in security. Otherwise, if the department ID equals 5, put in marketing. 4 equals manufacturing. 3, management. 2, IT. And if the department ID equals 1, put in accounting. Otherwise, make it unassigned. Then we've got our right parentheses. The first one for department ID equal to 1. There's 2, 3, 4, 5, and our closing parentheses for our department ID equaling 6. Let's select this, copy, and put that right into our dialog box. Now this looks nice right now, but once I hit OK, if I bring this back up, it doesn't quite look the same. It's close, but it doesn't have all that spacing. Let's run this and see if it works. And there we see all our departments showing up just how we would expect them. We notice in this report, we've got that employee ID of 0 with the required. We do not want this to show up in the report. I'm going to close this. I'm going to click down in this gray area. This brings up the data for the report. We got our table, employee table, and there's an area here for filter. I'm going to open up the dialog box, and I want to create a filter for employee ID, and it's saying where it's equal, and we want not equal. That will be this greater than or less than. If the employee ID is greater than or less than 0, then we want it to show up on the report. Let's run the report and show that it works. And employee ID of 0 is gone. If we go down to the bottom of this report, we'll notice that some of our employees don't have any hourly wage. We want to put in a message there. To do that, I'm going to go into hourly wage in the detail. I'm in the data tab. I'm going to open up our dialog box. Down here in our functions, we have something called ISBLANK. ISBLANK returns a true value, refers to an empty. So what we need is ISBLANK and then the value, which will be our hourly wage. We're still going to use this inside an if statement. So I want my logical if, and then inside of here, I'm just going to select all because I don't remember which category it's in, and click on is blank. Now I want to select the hourly wage. So we're saying if hourly wage is blank, now we want to get back into our if. So I'm clicking on the if. If it is blank, I'm going to put my message inside of double quotes, null value, double quote. Otherwise, I want to print out the hourly wage. This looks good. I'm going to click OK. And let's print the report. Down at the bottom, here we see no value, no value, no value. Now let's say that we want to highlight all the employees that make more than $40 an hour, like these two right here. To do that, I'm coming over to Format, Conditional Formatting. The field value is, and the field value we're looking at is our hourly wage, because I've got that selected here. It can be between, I want to say it is greater than, or how about greater than or equal to 40. And when it is, I will have this value turn to red, and we'll make this bold. Bold red when it's over 40 or equal, greater than or equal to 40. Going to run the report. And here we can see everyone that makes $40 an hour or more. Let's say we also want to highlight our no values, the people that have no hourly wage. I'll go back into Format, Conditional Formatting. It looks like we can only have one condition, but if we come down to this plus sign, now we can add another. If the field value is, we will say less than zero. If it's less than zero, I am going to make the background yellow. I will make the text blue. And also I will make this italic and bold. Let's run this and make sure it works. Coming down to the bottom, we see our italicized blue bold no value with the yellow background. That yellow background kind of stands out a little bit. To make that stand out less, I am just going to make the box a little smaller. Let's try that again. Scrolling down to the bottom, we see it looks a little better. It fits better. I'm going to close this, save the report. And save the database.